Hello everyone. In this video, you will learn how to use DS3231 real-time clock with Arduino, set up alarm, sense temperature, and get a clear concept about the library function associated with DS3231. To begin this project, you will need basically four things: a DS3231 RTC module, I2C LCD backpack, LCD module either 20x4 or 16x2, any Arduino flavor, and some jumper wire plus breadboard. I2C LCD adapter make it possible to use two-wire I2C bus on Arduino to control LCD, while RTC or real-time clock get us the current time which once written into is registered, and it will update automatically. Once written time to the RTC register, it keeps time even after the power is turned off with the help of an inbuilt battery attached to the back of this module. Also, our DS3231 RTC module has an inbuilt temperature sensor which is capable of measuring temperature along with the time, so the applications are limitless. Remember, on connecting I2C LCD adapter to the LCD module, connect the pin near this potentiometer for contrast adjustment to the first pin of LCD and the last pin near this jumper on I2C LCD adapter to the 16th pin of LCD. In an I2C, mainly there are two pins, serial clock line or SCL and serial data line or SDL. For Arduino Uno, analog pin 5 or A5 is the serial clock line and analog pin 4 or A4 is the serial data line. Connections are as per the diagram shown. SCL or analog pin 5 of Arduino goes to SCL line of I2C adapter and DS3231 RTC module. Similarly, SDA pin or A4 of Arduino Uno goes to SDL line of I2C adapter and DS3231. VCC goes to VCC and ground goes to ground. That's all. Check the description to download the connection schematic. Now, download the I2C LCD library and DS3231 RTC library from the description below. Extract the downloaded zip file and put them on the library folder inside your main Arduino IDE folder. Always try to use a single library, and if you have more than one library, remove the other before proceeding, since multiple libraries for a single hardware can cause some compiling issues. I already done a simple program and you can download it from the description below. I will explain everything based on this code.
Remember, do not upload the code without understanding it.
Okay, on the code, first of all, we want to include three libraries: wire.h for I2C communication, ds3231.h for RTC module, and LookinCrystal I2C for I2C LCD adapter interfacing. Next, we will initialize or set our LCD module. Here, you could change the value to 16x2 if you have a 16x2 LCD module, but I have 20x4 LCD module with me, so I will put the value 20 and 4. Then creating object named clock and DT in the classes DS3231 and RTC time respectively, and never change this value. Sometimes this will lead to some issues. On the setup function, to start LCD, we will call begin function using LCD object. If you don't know what an object or class is, just copy this line. Next, to turn on the backlight, we will use same object LCD along with the backlight function. Similar to LCD, using clock.begin, we initialize communication with RTC module. Next code is very important. To set date and time to the RTC, we will use set date and time function. To call this function, we will use our object clock created earlier. Input year, month, date, hours, minute and second as parameter to this function, and upload the sketch to the Arduino. Once you finished uploading, the date and time will be set on the RTC. So comment out or delete this line and re-upload the sketch again to the Arduino. If you won't do so, every time your Arduino reset, the time will be rewritten again to the RTC, leading to the wrong time. After successfully setting time on RTC, next we will learn about alarm 1 and alarm 2 on DS3231 RTC. They have their own register to which the alarm parameter like hour, minute or second, or even date can be written, and each of them will be armed based on the data written on their registers. Before setting alarm, you should disarm the two alarms using arm alarm function and clear the alarm registers using clear alarm function. One key point to remember while using DS3231 RTC library is that alarm 1 can be even triggered using second match, while alarm 2 can only be triggered up to minute match. That is, you cannot define seconds as a time parameter to trigger alarm in case of alarm 2, while you could use second as a parameter to trigger alarm 1. You can set an alarm, either alarm 1 or alarm 2, using set alarm function as shown in the examples below. The various format for setting alarm in DS3231 are given below. Okay, it's time to move to the next section. To continuously display our time, we will write the next lines of code on loop function. Using the object DT, we will get time and date using get date time function. setting cursor to the correct position LCD using set cursor function. Set cursor according to the type of LCD you have, either it is a 16x2 LCD or 20x4 LCD. Next code is very important. DS3231 library provide you with many time output format, 24-hour format, long number format, Unix time format, or even the most common 12-hour format. Refer example named DS3231 date format on this library for more detail. On the next LCD line, we will display temperature. It is noticeable that DS3231 RTC have an inbuilt temperature sensor whose value can be read out using read temperature function. Refer example once again for more detail on the example section of this library. To identify whether any alarm is raised, we will use isAlarm function. The isAlarm function will return true if alarm 1 or alarm 2 is raised based on how they are specified. You could turn on an LED or a buzzer, or even simply display a simple text alarm on an LCD using isAlarm function inside an if statement as shown in the code. Finally, here is the project output after uploading the code to the hardware we made before. Time is displayed on 24-hour format along with day, date and year. Temperature is displayed below it. You will see the text alarm 1 on below it because alarm 1 is set to second match mode and it will be triggered in every second. So this line of text will never disappear. Alarm 2 is set on minute match mode. As you can see, as we reach the next minute, a text will appear denoting alarm 2 is triggered. In this way, you could control almost anything from a blinky LED to an IoT-based home automation system or a server based on Arduino. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe, like and share my videos. Goodbye.